Hi there and welcome to this video. In this video, let's see how to install Docker on Ubuntu. And I will be using Ubuntu 24.04. I will install Docker Engine, not Docker Desktop. So my Ubuntu is running on VirtualBox. This means that you can follow along whether you're on Windows, Mac, or Linux. So first of all, let me start my machine here. It's already installed. So I'll just start it in headless mode. And that's because I've already set up SSH. I can log into that server via SSH. I'm going to open up terminal. If you don't know how to set up Ubuntu on VirtualBox such that you can SSH into that server, I have a video for that. I'm going to make sure I add it in the description below. So I'll just log into my server. Let me first of all check if there are any updates. No updates, so we can, so you can continue with the installation. Coming back here, I will add the link to this post in the description below. So of course, this is a new installation. I don't have anything old to uninstall. If you have anything to uninstall, you can run that. It will remove these old versions of Docker. And then the next consideration is the firewall. So Docker uses IP tables. If you have any of these, you can remove them because especially if you don't know how to set them up such that they're in a certain chain, a certain order, then just remove them and Docker will work directly with IP tables. So let me just copy that and I'll remove them. I'm sure I don't have any of this. Okay, so some of them which were there have been removed. Come back. The next step is to add the Docker Ubuntu repository, and this usually has the latest packages. That's why you want to add it. So I'm going to copy that. I've put everything together to make my work easier. I can just copy and run it in one go, but you can read everything and see what each of this does. Control Shift V to paste. There we go. Docker is installed. We can check if Docker is running. Sudo systemctl status docker. Okay, you can see Docker is enabled and running. Control C, Control L to close the screen. And now we can test installation of Docker packages. So I'll copy. So the first thing, of course, I've already checked the status of Docker, and I just want to check if Docker can run this. So I'm just going to copy that one to run the example container from Docker. Control Shift V, enter. Unable to find image, so it's going to try and pull it from the Docker repository. There we go. So this means that Docker can run. And Docker is working on our Ubuntu. Now, the only thing that we need to do next is to make sure that we don't have to run Docker with sudo. You see, in this command, I had to use sudo. And if I run it without sudo, you can see Docker permission denied. So we need to add our current user, our current user Ubuntu, into the Docker group. So let's come back here, and that is also here. So create the Docker group, probably already created, and then you need to add the user to the Docker group, and this is just going to replace it with the current user. If you want to add it for a specific user, just enter the username there, and that's what I'm going to do here, just as an example to show you that that's how it is done. So instead of using the user variable, I'm going to use the actual username, just just to show you that you can do this for any user on your system. User mode is used to modify users. Dash A simply means add this user to this group. Add to this group, Docker group, and we want to add this user. Control Shift C, Control Shift V to paste. And once we do this, we can now run. Once we do this, we actually need to log out of the system, and when we come back, we can run this. All right, for now, it's still telling you permission denied. So let me log out of the system. I can do exit to log out, and let me log back in. Log back into my Ubuntu server. And now let's try to run it. And now you can see it runs. Okay, so you have installed Docker. This is an error you might face, but really, if it happens, you can fix it like that. If you want to uninstall Docker engine, everything you've installed, so first of all, you'll uninstall all these packages, and then you'll remove these directories, and then remove this repository for Docker. All right, that's pretty much it for this tutorial for how to install Docker. If you want to learn how to use Docker, my intention is to create a series of tutorials showing you how to use Docker if you're a beginner. So that's it for this one. Follow the channel because I will create more Docker tutorials. Until next time.